you only dancing in the first one. What brought about singing? Did you ask to sing in this new Magic Mike film?
It really is all a testament to the generosity of Channing Tatum. We had no budget on the first movie. It was a tiny independent film that then later was acquired by a studio. So in between takes, we would entertain extras by just, or background actors by, you know, Channing would shove a microphone in your face and say, do something. And Joe Manganiello, who I went to college with at Carnegie Mellon, knew that I sang. He was like, you should sing a song. So I did, and Channing remembered that, and he was like, you're singing in this one. I was like, oh, man, because it's, you know, it's daunting just to have to take your clothes off in front of strangers and then to sing live on top of that was, you know.
I think I'd rather take my clothes off than sing, all things being equal. I don't want to do either, but I certainly don't. Singing in front of people would make me terrified.
It's, yeah, but there's something about taking your clothes off at the same time that actually made it easier.
Oh, well, there you
go. For me, I don't know.
Well, maybe I'll try that.
Just put it over the edge into some nether region of nervousness that I'd never experienced before.
You mentioned you went to college with Joe.
I did.
And so you guys went to Carnegie Mellon, great theater school.
Yeah.
Did you, do you remember, because he was mentioning you were there at the same time, did you did you have to do any of those, like, weird theater
school
things? Okay.
Yeah, we did animal projects together. I don't remember what Joe was. I was a peacock that you have to create a character out of an animal, and I became a heroin addict who worked at a tanning salon.
But also
but
a peacock.
But I was a peacock.
Yeah.
And we did clown work together. We've done Shakespeare together, and now we've stripped together.
Wow. That's fantastic.
I don't know where to go from here.
It's a very good start,
though. What is the next logical step?
And did you like being in Pittsburgh? I always like people who...
I love Pittsburgh.
Yeah.
It really grew on me over the course of 4 years. I'm from Texas, so there was a little period of adjustment, but I love it there.
You, and then one of your early jobs in this business before you were Max Bomer was you were in a soap opera.
Yes.
And is this true that for the soap opera, you knew you weren't going to be there for a long time, so you basically asked the writers, like, just come up with whatever you can?
Oh, yeah. I told them to just throw the kitchen sink at me.
How long were you there? How long were you on?
I was there just over a year.
So what happened to your character in the course of 1 year?
Are you ready for this?
I am ready for this.
Okay, I was a trust fund baby who bet my fraternity brothers that I could be the first to deflower the town virgin.
Okay.
I fell in love with her, but she found out about the bet and dumped me. I met a new girlfriend, lost my trust fund, was embarrassed to tell her, so I became a male prostitute. Because that's what you do when you lose your trust fund. I had all these, like, cougar clients, these women I would meet at, like, 6 in the morning, and by 9 a.m. we'd be in the bed together making out for, like, 5 minutes. And then my girlfriend found out that I was a male prostitute, dumped me, of course.
Sure.
And then I went crazy, killed 5 people, kidnapped her to a remote cabin in the woods.
Oh, no.
Confessed to her that I'd been molested by my middle school teacher.
Oh, no.
And then committed suicide in front of her, her father, and her new boyfriend. Then hung on one day in the hospital to confess my sins.
Oh, my goodness. Wow. So everything else is just child's play.
It was a lot, but my favorite moment, the writers came up to me at the end of it, and they go, listen, if you ever want to come back, we've got it figured out. I don't know what that was, but I want to know, like, what was your plan?
Yeah.
Like, how do you resuscitate
well,
that?
Well, also, all the other stuff's so crazy. I feel like the plan is, here's what we came up with. You're just not dead.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You're a twin.
Yeah. It's a shame that won't happen, but I guess the door's still open.
Okay.
Yeah. Thank you so much for being here. Always such a pleasure
to
see you.
Thank you so much.
Matt Bomer!